As we think about problems that our society faces, it's becoming increasingly evident that we need to find new solutions to help address sustainability goals. One of the things that we're looking to address is how do we engineer organisms that can convert simple products in the atmosphere, like carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, and others, into products that we use in our daily lives.
The reason I was interested in materials was always because I was looking for more sustainable or environmentally friendly solutions and making sustainable materials, but it was only coming to Northwestern that I realized that we could also use the same sorts of techniques that we're doing to engineer materials to also break them down. And it turns out just in 2011 in Japan, researchers actually discovered an organism that was able to degrade the polyethylene terephthalate, which is polyester, and we need to make that more of an industrial scale because there's a lot of plastic around.
So bacteria naturally sense their environment, and they do it through these neat little molecular machines called biosensors. These machines can be proteins or RNA molecules, and they fold up into these intricate little shapes, and those shapes create a little specific binding pocket. So one of these proteins, for example, has a little pocket that only catches the lead ion that is toxic to us. So we had been studying these processes for a number of years and knew how to manipulate them, how to take that lead sensing molecule and hook it up like Legos to a different molecule that will produce a signal. Now, once you can do that for lead in water, you can think about other types of contaminants, be they water contaminants, or maybe you're interested in a toxin or a health marker in your own body. And so the same type of technology can be used for that.